In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to set up your sales funnel in ConvertKit. My name is Haley Dale, and I'm a sales funnel and content strategist. And so in this little series, I've been going through my top recommendations for email service providers and walking you through how to set up your sales funnel using them. So if you happen to be using one another tool, definitely check out those other videos and walkthroughs that I have done. But in this video, we are focused on ConvertKit, and ConvertKit is a great email service provider. I have a lot of clients who are on it. I actually use it for one of my other side businesses. And so I'm going to walk you through this account here and just kind of guide you through where to find things and then specifically how to set up your sales funnel and then how to measure that sales funnel, where to get that data so you know how if it is working. Okay, so when you log into ConvertKit, so first off, if you sign up for a brand new account, you're going to need to authenticate your email address before it's going to let you really do much in here. So I'm using an existing account. We've recently migrated from this, but we used it for one of my side businesses for quite a while. So I'm going to walk you through how to use it here. All right. So when you log in to ConvertKit, after you've authenticated your email address, you're going to have some info here. So when you log in, you're going to be brought to this dashboard, and it's basically just going to show you your subscriber growth, your total subscribers, average opens and click rates, how many emails have been sent. It'll also give you a summary of how many new subscribers that day, which is really great. You'll have all of your tags and segments down here, and then your confirmed subscribers will be there as well. Up near the top is where the automations are. So this is where you're going to build out those visual funnels and visual automations that you're building. They also have something called sequences, which used to be separate, but they're actually in automations now. So that's where you're actually going to put your emails. But I'm going to walk you through how to do that. And then we have landing pages and forms. So like one of the other tools we went over, MailerLite, as well as recently ActiveCampaign, you can build landing pages directly in here. There are some limitations to them, but I want to show you that. And then we also have broadcasts, and this is where you are going to send your one-off emails. So not your funnels, but you'll go in there for those one-off emails. I also like with this data thing, you can also put deliverability. Oh, that's for pro. You can put purchases. If you have this integrated, you can have total subscribers here. So you can kind of like narrow this down and just look at specific groups or specific tags in this case, and look at it that way. So you can do it here, and you can narrow the dates here as well. So if you just want to look at August or just want to look at a specific week, you can do that. One of my cons for ConvertKit, and we're going to get there in a little bit, is that it doesn't have this filtering option for all of your funnel automation. So it's very hard to kind of like, you need to keep track of the numbers in order and like minus the latest numbers from the last time you measured in order to get those measurements for the automations. But that's like the one downside to this, and I'll walk you through where to find that, but just kind of a heads up on that one. So when we walk through our funnel, the first thing that we're going to do is I have my, so in this document that I have open, I also just have some dummy tags here. So anytime that I'm creating a funnel, I like to create a freebie. I keep all my freebies the same format. So it goes freebie and then name of freebie. I also have the same thing for offer, name of offer. And what this means is that everyone with this freebie tag has downloaded the freebie. So that way I can find them in my tag. Same thing for the offer. Anyone with this offer tag has purchased the offer. And that way I can filter out the people who've purchased or send a message just to the people who have purchased the offer. Then for every funnel I create, I also create these tags, a current and complete tag. And this is a way to make sure that people aren't receiving the same email multiple times. But if they sign up for the freebie later on, they can still get it. So this is funnel, offer name, so the offer that this funnel leads to, current, and then funnel, offer name, complete. And that means that they've finished the funnel. This means that they're currently in it. So when I am setting up a funnel, the very first thing that I will do is set up my tags. So you're going to do that directly from the dashboard, and you're going to come down here to tags, and you're going to go create a tag. Then you're just going to put them in, and I'm just going to put these dummy tags in here. So that way, oh, looks like we have already, let's see, freebie. Oh, there we go. We did create it. Okay. So let's do funnel offer name current. Okay, and let's do funnel offer name complete. So the very first thing I do when I'm setting up a new funnel is I create my tagging. I create what the tags are going to be, and then I will go and create the tags in the email service provider. Okay, so then the second thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go and create my form. So I'm going to come over to landing pages and forms up at the top here, and you can see some of the forms that I have for this little side business. But what we're going to do is we are going to create a new one. And you have an option here when you click create, you can create a landing page or you can create a form. If you want to create a landing page, you can do that within their platform, which is really nice because you can just build it everything in here and just drive traffic to this landing page. We're going to just create a form, but I'm going to walk you through at the end how to set up that landing page. So I like just to create so you can do an inline, you can do, this is a pop-up modal, this is a slide-in, so I'm kind of like a pop-up, and then a sticky bar at the top of your website. For purposes of simplicity, I'm just going to stick with this inline one. And then we have some different templates that we can choose from here. So I'm going to choose Charlotte. It tends to be one of my favorite ones. I like Poplar too. So we'll choose that. Then what we're going to do is sign up to get my checklist. We would probably put what it actually was. And then to actually put the change the image here, what we would do is we would just click over to general styles, and then you can replace this image, and you can just choose something. You can use one of their images as well. So let's just use let's use this one. I'm not particular. I'm kind of picky about my stock photos. Then you can change the form background, the border radius. If you have any custom CSS, you can add it there as well. We can also click on your first name. We can make that required. I usually always make it required because I like to address my emails to people. And then email address is obviously required. Then you can change what this button says. So let's see. We can just go, yes. Send me the guide, the checklist. I'd probably keep that to one line. Then this built on ConvertKit, we can actually turn it off so that way it doesn't have that on there. And then what we want to do is we want to then go to settings. And what's really great is settings. So when a visitor subscribes to the form, you can redirect to an external page. And this is where I would put in my thank you page. And I'll just pop it in there. And then we can choose domain name if you want. This is more for pages. I think forms, you can just keep them as is. Incentive email. Now, this is my favorite feature of ConvertKit versus the other tools out there. So instead of getting a double opt-in is a great idea, but it is not necessary for most of the US. I think right now, none of the US. California is getting close to requiring it. So in this case, that means we can have that incentive email. And basically, when it sends them the confirmation email and they click on it, they'll also download the freebie. So it's kind of double purpose. And another thing about ConvertKit is you don't need to host your PDF files on, say, Amazon S3 or Dropbox. You can just have them here. So what we can do is send incentive email, and we would just go, you know, you can put where it was from, and you can go, your checklist is inside. Oh, inside, I can't spell. Then you can change this email, put hello, everything like that. And then confirm subscription. You can change this button. You can change it to, click to confirm and download your checklist. Can change anything like that. And then what you do is just go save. And then for the download, what you would do is click download here, and then you could just upload your PDF file here. So I really like to do that because that way it's kind of double purpose. It's not sending a bunch of emails just for the sake of it. So when you're done, click save. And then I would also change the name of this, and I like to keep it the same thing as my freebie. So we'll just change that. Now, other settings that we want to just look over here is you can have the invisible captcha, you can send subscriber to a thank you page, but you've already set that. So I think we are good to go here. So the other thing you can do once you're ready is just click save once it's ready to go. And then your sign up form is done. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to set up your automation. So they've already gotten the freebie, but we need to set up the rest of your automation here. So click automation. Then what you're going to do is just click on new automation, and we're going to name this, and I name this one funnel offer name. OK, Okay. And then create automation. They also have some great templates here. We're going to start from scratch. So joins a form, and we're going to choose our new form that we've created. You can also have when they're added to a tag. So if they purchase something, you can have a follow-up. You can also have purchase there or custom field. I think it's easier just to do the form here because like ActiveCampaign, you can have multiple entry points. So you can create other forms here that they join. It's not like MailerLite where we want to do it from a group because you can't add in multiple ones. So then what we're going to do is we are going to add them to our tag. So we can't set the tag. This is very different than the other ones, the other tools that I've gone over, is that in the forms, you can set up a little automation that adds them to a tag, but you may as well just do it in this automation here. So you have to do it separately. You don't set it at the form level. So add or remove to tag, and we're going to add them to that name of freebie. Okay. So then what we're going to do is we are going to send an email. And we actually need to create a new sequence here. So we're going to have freebie. So we are going to have freebie name of offer. Okay. So we'll go add action. Okay. And then this doesn't actually add the email. So what you need to do is you need to click on this and then it'll add you, then it'll show you the sequence where you can add the email, and you can also add other ones here, or you can just add one. So what you would have here is like, welcome to Daring CEO. You could change all of your info here. You can add buttons. You can add everything there. But then when you're done, you want to check on active. And then the other thing I recommend is go 0 days. So even though technically you want to wait, it's like if you were going to add multiple emails within the sequence, but we're going to add them all as individual emails here. So we're going to put active, we're going to put immediately, and then we're going to go save. Then what we're going to do is we are going to check and see. So we need to add a condition. So basically, if somebody signs up for this freebie, we want them to get it, but then we don't want to send them the rest of the emails if they're currently in the sequence, like say they sign up a day later or they've completed it. So we're going to check and see condition tag. And this is where we're going to go look for our current. Are they currently in it? And then this is the other annoying part, is that you need to add every check separately. So if they aren't, if they don't have this tag, we also need to check and see if they have the complete tag. There we go. Okay. So then if it's a yes, it'll end the sequence. It'll end the sequence. But if it's a no, then what we're going to do is add our 1 day delay. Say it was 1 day, then we're going to add our next email. And so we could put in the title of the email here. So this one might be nurture email number one. Let's see, Addy, and we'll go nurture emails, and we're just going to put this all in one sequence. So I know I said that we are going to do it in separate ones, but I think you can keep the nurture ones together. It's the sales emails we'll want to pull out. So then we'll click on this, and here's where we can build this. So nurture email number one, but you'd actually put this, you'd put your actual subject line there. Don't put that. And then here we would say number two, or as many nurture emails as you have. Then we would go active. We're going to put 0 days on this, so it gets sent automatically, since in the funnel, we've already put our delay here. But for this nurture email, we want to turn it active. Let's see. We're going to turn that active, but we are going to put a delay there. So say it was 2 days that we wanted to wait. You could also put, like, say I don't want emails to send on Sunday. You could put that too. So you can have a bit more customization there. So then we put our nurture emails right in here. And then once the nurture emails are done, we want to check and see if they've purchased the offer. So we're going to have another condition here, and we're going to check for a tag, and we're going to check for that offer, name of offer. Okay. And then what we'll do is if they don't have it, then we're going to add our delay. So maybe it's like 1 day we want to wait, and then we're going to add our sales email. So we're going to go email sequence, and then we're going to go offer name, sales emails. And so in the other tools that I showed you, unlike ActiveCampaign, you can set a goal to pull people out. MailerLite, you need to have a check before each sales email. We're going to have a different way of doing this. So we can add all of our sales emails in this sequence here. So we click on it, sales email number one. You'd put your actual subject line here. Don't put sales email number one. So it might be last chance or get great news. This is now available. Then I'm going to turn this active. I'm going to have a 0 day delay for this first one. Then this one might be active, and let's say I had a 2 day delay, and then I would just save it. And then when they're done, what I want to do is I want to, so we're going to do it here. We need to remove the tag. So add, so we want to add the complete tag underneath the sales emails. We want to remove the current tag. So click remove, and then you can just type current. Make sure you're selecting the right one as you have more funnels and more tags. We also need to put the same tags here. So we need to add them to complete so they don't get that again, because this would pull them out. So add, we want to add complete. And we want to remove current before it ends the sequence. There we go. Okay. Perfect. So then when you're ready to turn this live, you are going to turn that on. So turn it on and then you're ready to go. So next I'm going to click on automations. And this is where I wanted to show you how to pull people out of the sequence if they purchase the offer. So what we want to do is we want to go to rules here. So automations, rules, and we want to say, so add a rule and then trigger when a tag is added, and we want to add them to that tag. So when they get the offer, name of offer, meaning that they've purchased the offer, we want to unsubscribe them from a sequence, and we're going to choose those offer name sales emails. This way it's not going to continue sending them those sales emails if they've purchased. So click on save rule there, and then that is good to go. Now in terms of finding the metrics, once this automation is set up and it's running and people are there, what you would do here is you would click on the actual emails. So you would click here, and then your emails are going to come up, and then you're going to go to reports. And so this is going to show you the open rate, the click-through rate, the number of sends, and the number of unsubscribes. If you want more details on it, click on the name of the email, and it'll also show you the open rate and the click-through rate. You can see the recipients. Now, as I was saying, my one downfall for ConvertKit is I really wish it let you set like August or September or between these dates. Like, you need to do a little bit of math to figure this out. We run into this issue a lot when we're measuring our funnels for our clients. And so we need to track what the number is at every single point that we measure, so we can do a subtraction to find out what the current numbers are for that change. So I hope this was helpful. In terms of extras, I wanted to show you quickly the pages here. So what you do is go to landing pages and forms. And this is one of my perks, I think, for ConvertKit versus some of the other tools out there. So you'd click new, you'd click landing page, and then you have some really great templates here. They don't have too much customization, like not a lot of drag and drop that other tools have, but you do have quite a few templates here, and they're quite pretty. So you could take these and customize them as far as ConvertKit will let you. So it's not complete carte blanche, but it is nice to have this tool in there. So say that I was choosing this one. I could, yeah, so I can't like drag and drop new things like some of the other tools. Like, I can't drag and drop new text blocks or new headers, but I can change the background, I can change the headings, the body font, I can change, let's see, you can change, like you can actually click and then it gives you some more options in here. I could add in the first name here too. First name required, put it up there. Now, when you're finished this, you want to name your page, but I just wanted to show you in settings. So once you're done, you can choose a domain. So you could choose, it sets you up a domain on CK page. That means ConvertKit page, but you can also put what this is. So say this was for the Daring CEO roadmap. You can save that as well. And then in that way, you can kind of control what that final domain is going to be. And then, so here's your domain for this opt-in page once it is published. So this is what you would promote for people to sign up for your freebie. All right. So if you have any questions, make sure to ask them below this video. Otherwise, go and check out the other walkthrough funnel setup tutorials if you don't happen to be using ConvertKit or you just want to check them out before you commit to one.